Alright, now you pay attention to me, because I'm going to tell you something really important. Death is not what you think it is. Death does not set you free from any of your addictions or problems. Actually, it's the very opposite. Death forces you to continue just the way you were in life, because the only chance that you had to change it was when you were alive, and you wasted. Unfair, isn't it? By the way, hello, I'm Jimi Hendrix. Well, I don't remember exactly how I died. I do remember that I was in a party in London with my girlfriend Monica. We were having fun and I drank so much wine. Everything that happened after this is diffuse. At some moment, we went back to the hotel, I took some sleeping pills and then I died. The toughest part of this story when my businessman influenced my death. He paid people to give me drink after drink. Because he wanted something like this to happen, he wanted me dead. But I'm not stupid and I don't blame him completely. I know that it's not entirely his fault. I could have denied the wine, but I didn't. I was young and I didn't think too much about my future. It was other times too, the 60s, drugs, bro, everything was so new. Nowadays, I'm still considered one of the best guitarists ever, and I'm really proud of it. But I always think, if I was one of the best of the age of 27, if I had lived more, which things would I have reached?
You know, man, the funniest part of this is that until just a few years ago, I wouldn't need to tell you who I am. Like, I don't want to sound cocky or anything like this, but what can I say? Sometimes everything is so crazy that I didn't even know what is going on in my life, but people like me anyway just because I used to sing well. What is pathetic, not a nice reason. Whatever. Now I'm gonna introduce myself to you, the new generation. My name is Janis Joplin. Better I tell you a little about me too. I was born in Port Arthur, a small city in Texas in the 1943. And to make a long story short, I died in the 1970 after a heroin overdose. See, by the time I died, I was already a junkie for 7 years. I knew how to use a heroin the right way, but I was out of my mind and I completely lost control. My businessman found my body later in the same day because I didn't show up in the music record. And here's the punchline. People call me the queen of rock and roll even nowadays. Many fans adore me. And who am I? The talented girl who made the worst choice and died? There's many others like this. This one I learned after my death, but I want you to learn right now. Every mistake you make on purpose, you make a dozen others for accident. You know you got it, China, that makes you feel good.
Do I really need to introduce myself? Damn. Right. Kurt Cobain, nice to meet you. You happy now? Look guys, I haven't planned anything to say to you, and I really don't care about this stupid video. Still, I'm here, so let's talk. In life, I was vocalist of the band Nirvana, and no, I'm not proud of even half of the things I've done in my last years. People still like to point me and judge me without knowing anything. It's not because you listen to my music that you know me. And who was I? A junkie? Yes. A musician? Yes. A suicidal? Yes. But also a husband and a father of a baby girl. I was a person, and everybody sold and bought my depression like it was just entertainment. And I end up blowing my brains out. And I ask you this. What if it was you in my situation? So addicted that you couldn't even think. I was like this. I want to take care of my daughter. I want to be rational, but it was impossible. And I just couldn't take it anymore. So I did what I did. I take the consequence of what even today. I couldn't see friends growing up. I don't know what happened to my wife Courtney. I don't know if she's dead or alive because I'm here in the 27th prison. It's... Never mind. I just want to say you to be good people, to valorize your family, while you still have them, and to always try to be your best, so you won't end up like me.
What? Is it recording? God, I'm sorry. Hi, people. My name is Emma Winehouse, as you probably already know. So, I was invited to tell you my story today, so I would take the opportunity to demystify a few things about me. First, no, I didn't have an overdose. I mean, yeah, I certainly had overdoses, but it wasn't what killed me. In fact, I took the medication they gave me in rehab and drank it with alcohol. So I had intoxication, I'm dead, and blah, blah, blah. Never liked to talk about my life though, and I definitely hate to talk about my death. I always liked music, and for me that was all along the way. I can't understand how I lost myself, it just happened. Just like happened with many musicians before me. The truth is that I never wanted to be famous, I never asked for any of this. I wanted to play my music and be who I am, who I was. Maybe I'd have been happier if I just played in the night like many others instead of recording albums and stuff. I know I should have said no. No, I'm not going to it. No, that's not the way I am. That's not the way I want to be. Hey, can everybody hear me? I could have saved myself of all of this. I tried, I looked for help, but it was just too late. I already was the M. Winehouse.
Nothing lasts forever. I'm sorry, I can't be perfect. Now it's just too late, and we can't go.